This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. 18,205,898 56% of U.S. population 2011 U.S. Census Bureau estimate regions with significant populations throughout the United States, especially Hawaii, the West Coast, and major urban areas elsewhere languages American English Asian languages religion Christian 42% unaffiliated 26% Buddhist 14% Hindu 10% Muslim 4% Sikh 1% other 2% including Jain. Related ethnic groups Asian Americans of Hispanic and Latino ethnicity Asian Americans are Americans of Asian descent. The term refers to a panethnic group that includes diverse populations who have ancestral origins in East Asia, Southeast Asia, or South Asia, as defined by the U.S. Census Bureau. This includes people who indicate their races on the census as Asian or reported entries such as Asian Indian, Chinese, Filipino, Korean, Japanese, Sri Lankan, Thai, Vietnamese, or other Asian origin. Groups Asian Americans with no other ancestry comprise 48% of the U.S. population, while people who are Asian alone or combined with at least one other race make up 56%. Although migrants from Asia have been in parts of the contemporary United States since the 17th century, large-scale immigration did not begin until the mid-18th century. Nativist immigration laws during the 1880s to 1920s excluded various Asian groups, eventually prohibiting almost all Asian immigration to the continental United States after immigration laws were reformed during the 1940s to 60s, abolishing national origins quotas, Asian immigration increased rapidly. Analyses of the 2010 census have shown that Asian Americans are the fastest growing racial or ethnic minority in the United States starting in the first few years of the 2000 decade. Asian American earnings began exceeding all other racial groups for both men and women. For example, in 2008 Asian Americans had the highest median household income overall of any racial demographic. In 2012, Asian Americans had the highest educational attainment level and median household income of any racial demographic in the country. In 2015, Asian American men were the highest earning racial group as they earned 117% as much as white American men, and Asian American women earned 106% as much as white American women. Despite this, a 2014 report from the Census Bureau reported that 12% of Asian Americans were living below the poverty line, while only 101% of non-Hispanic white Americans live below the poverty line once country of birth and other demographic factors are taken into account. Asian Americans are no more likely than non-Hispanic whites to live in poverty. Contents 1 Terminology 11 Census Definition 12 Debates 2 Demographics 21 Religion 3 History 31 Early Immigration 32 Exclusion Era 33 Post-war immigration 34 Asian American movement 4 Notable contributions 41 Arts and entertainment 42 Business 43 Government and politics 44 Journalism 45 Military 46 Science and technology 461 Award recipients 462 Space 47 Sports 471 Basketball 472 Football 473 Mixed martial arts 474 Olympics 475 Other sports 5 Cultural influence 51 Health and medicine 52 Education 6 Social and political issues 61 Illegal immigration 611 Deportation of Cambodians from the United States 62 Race-based violence 63 Racial stereotypes 631 Model minority 64 Bamboo ceiling 7 Progress as a group within American society 8 See also 9 References 10 Further reading 11 External links Terminology See also, Asian people and definitions of whiteness in the United States as with other racial and ethnicity-based terms, formal and common usage have changed markedly through the short history of this term prior to the late 1960s. People of Asian ancestry were usually referred to as Oriental, Asiatic, and Mongoloid. Additionally, the American definition of Asian originally included West Asian ethnic groups, particularly Afghan Americans, Jewish Americans, Armenian Americans, Assyrian Americans, and Arab Americans. Although these groups are now considered Middle Eastern American, the term Asian American was coined by historian Yuji Ichioka, who is credited with popularizing the term, to frame a new inter-ethnic pan-Asian American self-defining political group in the late 1960s changing patterns of immigration, and an extensive period of exclusion of Asian immigrants, have resulted in demographic changes that have in turn affected the formal and common understandings of what defines Asian American. For example, since the removal of restrictive national origins quotas in 1965, the Asian American population has diversified greatly to include more of the peoples with ancestry from various parts of Asia. Today, Asian American is the accepted term for most formal purposes, such as government and academic research, although it is often shortened to Asian in common usage. The most commonly used definition of Asian American is the U.S. Census Bureau definition, which includes all people with origins in the Far East, Southeast Asia, and the Indian subcontinent. This is chiefly because the census definitions determine many government classifications, notably for equal opportunity programs and measurements. According to the Oxford English Dictionary, Asian person in the United States is sometimes thought of as a person of East Asian descent. In vernacular usage, Asian is often used to refer to those of East Asian descent or anyone else of Asian descent with epicontic eyefolds. This differs from the U.S. Census definition, and the Asian American Studies departments in many universities consider all those of East, South, or Southeast Asian descent to be Asian. Census definition in the U.S. Census: people with origins or ancestry in the Far East, Southeast Asia, and the Indian subcontinent are classified as part of the Asian race, while those with origins or ancestry in North Asia, Russians, Siberians, Central Asia Kazakhs, Uzbeks, Turkmens, etc., the Western Asia diaspora Jews, Turks, Persians, West Asian Arabs, etc., and the Caucasus Georgians, Armenians, Azeris are classified as white or Middle Eastern. Before 1980, census forms listed particular Asian ancestries as separate groups, along with white and black or Negro Asian Americans had also been classified as other. In 1977, the Federal Office of Management and Budget issued a directive requiring government agencies to maintain statistics on racial groups, including on Asian or Pacific Islander. The 1980 census marked the first classification of Asians as a large group, combining several individual ancestry groups into Asian or Pacific Islander. By the 1990 census, Asian or Pacific Islander API was included as an explicit category, although respondents had to select one particular ancestry as a subcategory. The 2000 census onward separated the category into two separate ones, Asian American and Native Hawaiian and other Pacific Islander. Debates: the definition of Asian American has variations that derive from the use of the word American in different contexts: immigration status, citizenship by birthright and by naturalization, acculturation, and language ability are some variables that are used to define American for various purposes and may vary in formal and everyday usage. For example, restricting American to include only U.S. citizens conflicts with discussions of Asian American businesses, which generally refer both to citizen and non-citizen owners. In a PBS interview from 2004, a panel of Asian American writers discussed how some groups include people of Middle Eastern descent in the Asian American category. Asian American author Stuart Akeda has noted, the definition of Asian American also frequently depends on who's asking, who's defining, in what context, and why. The possible definitions of Asian Pacific American are many, complex, and shifting. Some scholars in Asian American studies conferences suggest that Russians, Iranians, and Israelis all might fit the field's subject of study. Jeff Young, of the Wall Street Journal, writes that the pan-ethnic definition of Asian American is a unique American construct, and as an identity is, in beta. Scholars have grappled with the accuracy, correctness, and usefulness of the term Asian American. The term Asian in Asian American most often comes under fire for encompassing a huge number of people with ancestry from or who have immigrated from a wide range of culturally diverse countries and traditions. In contrast, leading social sciences and humanities scholars of race and Asian American identity point out that because of the racial constructions in the United States, including the social attitudes toward race and those of Asian ancestry, Asian Americans have a shared racial experience. Because of this shared experience, the term Asian American is still a useful panethnic category because of the similarity of some experiences among Asian Americans, including stereotypes specific to people in this category. Demographics: Asian American population percentage by state in 2010, Asian percentage by county, 2010. Main article: Demographics of Asian Americans. The demographics of Asian Americans describe a heterogeneous group of people in the United States who can trace their ancestry to one or more countries in in Asia because Asian Americans comprise 5% of the entire U.S. population. The diversity of the group is often disregarded in media and news discussions of Asians or of Asian Americans. While there are some commonalities across ethnic subgroups, there are significant differences among different Asian ethnicities that are related to each group's history. The demographics of Asian Americans can further be subdivided into East Asian Americans, including Chinese Americans, Japanese Americans, Korean Americans, Mongolian Americans, and Taiwanese Americans. South Asian Americans, including Bangladeshi Americans, Bhutanese Americans, Indian Americans, Nepalese Americans, Pakistani Americans, Sri Lankan Americans, and Tibetan Americans. Southeast Asian Americans, including Burmese Americans, Cambodian Americans, Filipino Americans, Hmong Americans, Indonesian Americans, Laotian Americans, Malaysian Americans, Mien Americans, Singaporean Americans, Thai Americans, and Vietnamese Americans. Asian Americans include multiracial or mixed-race persons with origins or ancestry in both the above groups and another race, or multiple of the above groups. Religion. A 2012 Pew Research Center study found the following breakdown of religious identity among Asian Americans: 42% Christian, 26% unaffiliated with any religion, 14% Buddhist, 10% Hindu, 4% Muslim, 2% other religion, 1% Sikh. Christianity among Asian Americans has seen a sharp decline since the 1990s. In 1990, 63% of the Asian Americans identified as Christians, while in 2001 only 43% still did. This decline of Christianity has been accompanied by a rise in traditional Asian religions, with the people identifying with them doubling during the same decade. History. Main article: History of Asian Americans. See also: Asian immigration to the United States, early immigration, 5 images of the Filipino settlement at St. Malo, Louisiana. As Asian Americans originate from many different countries, each population has its own unique immigration history. Romani people began emigrating to North America in colonial times, with small groups recorded in Virginia and French Louisiana. Larger scale Roma emigration to the United States would follow subsequently. Filipinos have been in the territories that would become the United States since the 16th century. The earliest known arrival is that of Luzonians in Morro Bay, California, on board the Manila-built galleon ship Nuestra Senora de Esperanza in 1587, when both the Philippines and California were colonies of the Spanish Empire. In 1635, an East Indian is listed in Jamestown, Virginia, preceding wider settlement of Indian immigrants on the East Coast in the 1790s and the West Coast in the 1800s. In 1763, Filipinos established the small settlement of St. Malo, Louisiana, after fleeing mistreatment aboard Spanish ships. Since there were no Filipino women with them, these Manilaman, as they were known, married Cajun and Native American women. The first Japanese person to come to the United States and stay any significant period of time was Nakahama Manjiro, who reached the East Coast in 1841, and Joseph Hecko became the first Japanese American naturalized U.S. citizen in 1858. Chinese sailors first came to Hawaii in 1789, a few years after Captain James Cook came upon the island. Many settled and married Hawaiian women. Most Chinese, Korean, and Japanese immigrants in Hawaii arrived in the 19th century as laborers to work on sugar plantations. There were thousands of Asians in Hawaii when it was annexed to the United States in 1898. Later, Filipinos also came to work as laborers, attracted by the job opportunities, although they were limited. Large-scale migration from Asia to the United States began when Chinese immigrants arrived on the West Coast in the mid-19th century, forming part of the California Gold Rush. These early Chinese immigrants participated intensively in the mining business and later in the construction of the Transcontinental Railroad. By 1852, the number of Chinese immigrants in San Francisco had jumped to more than 20,000. A wave of Japanese immigration to the United States began after the Meiji Restoration in 1868. In 1898, all Filipinos in the Philippine Islands became American nationals when the United States took over colonial rule of the islands from Spain following the latter's defeat in the Spanish-American War. Exclusion era under United States law. During this period, particularly the Naturalization Act of 1790, only free white persons were eligible to naturalize as American citizens. Ineligibility for citizenship prevented Asian immigrants from accessing a variety of rights, such as voting. In a pair of cases, Ozawa v. United States States 1922 and United States v. Bhagat Singh, thinned 1923, the Supreme Court upheld the racial qualification for citizenship and ruled that Asians were not white persons, second-generation Asian Americans, however, could become U.S. citizens due to the Birthright Citizenship Clause of the 14th Amendment. This guarantee was confirmed as applying regardless of race or ancestry by the Supreme Court in United States v. Wong Kim Ark 1898. From the 1880s to the 1920s, the United States passed laws inaugurating an era of exclusion of Asian immigrants, although the absolute numbers of Asian immigrants were small compared to that of immigrants from other regions. Much of it was concentrated in the West, and the increase caused some nativist sentiment known as the Yellow Peril. Congress passed restrictive legislation prohibiting nearly all Chinese immigration in the 1880s. Japanese immigration was sharply curtailed by a diplomatic agreement in 1907. The Asiatic Barred Zone Act in 1917 further barred immigration from South Asia, then British India, Southeast Asia, and the Middle East. The Immigration Act of 1924 provided that no alien ineligible for citizenship could be admitted as an immigrant to the United States, consolidating the prohibition of Asian immigration. Post-war immigration. World War II era legislation and judicial rulings gradually increased the ability of Asian Americans to immigrate and become naturalized citizens. Immigration rapidly increased following the enactment of the Immigration and Nationality Act amendments of 1965, as well as the influx of refugees from conflicts occurring in Southeast Asia such as the Vietnam War. Asian American immigrants have a significant percentage of individuals who have already achieved professional status, a first among immigration groups. In 2009, Asian Americans surpassed Hispanic Americans as the largest plurality of immigrants to the United States. Additionally, from 2000 to 2010, the Asian American population was the fastest growing group according to the 2010 U.S. Census. Asian American Movement. Main article, Asian American Movement. The Asian American Movement refers to a pan-Asian movement in the United States in which Americans of Asian descent came together to fight against their shared oppression and to organize for recognition and advancement of their shared cause during the 1960s to the early 1980s. According to William Way, the movement was rooted in a past history of oppression and a present struggle for liberation. This occurred around the same time as the Chicano movement, civil rights movement, American Indian movement, and the gay liberation movement. Notable contributions. See also, List of Asian Americans Arts and Entertainment. Main article, Asian Americans in Arts and Entertainment. See also, Asian American Literature. Asian Americans have been involved in the entertainment industry since the first half of the 19th century, when Chong and Eng Bunker, the original Siamese twins, became naturalized citizens. Acting roles in television, film, and theater were relatively few, and many available roles were for narrow, stereotypical characters. More recently, young Asian American comedians and filmmakers have found an outlet on YouTube, allowing them to gain a strong and loyal fanbase among their fellow Asian Americans. There have been several Asian American-centric television shows in American media, beginning with Mr. T and Tina in 1976, and as recent as Fresh Off the Boat in 2015. Throughout the 1990s, there was a growing amount of Asian American queer writings, and today the list of contributing writers is long, to name a few: Merle Wu 1941, Willis Kim 1946, Russell Leong 1950, Kitty Sui 1952, Dwight Okita 1958, Norman Wong 1963, Tim Liu 1965, Shea Yu 1965, and Justin Chin 1969. Business. This article lacks historical information on the subject. Please help to add historical material to help counter systemic bias towards recent information. August 2009, co-founder of Yahoo Jerry Yang. When Asian Americans were largely excluded from labor markets in the 19th century, they started their own businesses. They have started convenience and grocery stores, professional offices such as medical and law practices, laundries, restaurants, beauty-related ventures, high-tech companies, and many other kinds of enterprises, becoming very successful and influential in American society. They have dramatically expanded their involvement across the American economy. Asian Americans have been disproportionately successful in the high-tech sectors of California's Silicon Valley, as evidenced by the Gold C100 compilation of America's most successful Asian entrepreneurs compared to their population base. Asian Americans today are well represented in the professional sector and tend to earn higher wages. The Gold C compilation of notable Asian American professionals show that many have come to occupy high positions at leading U.S. corporations, including a surprising number as chief marketing officers, Asian Americans have made major contributions to the American economy in 2012. Asian Americans own 15 million businesses, employ around 3 million people who earn an annual total payroll of around $80 billion. Fashion designer and mogul Vera Wang, who is famous for designing dresses for high-profile celebrities, started a clothing company, named after herself, which now offers a broad range of luxury fashion products, and Wang founded Wang Laboratories in June 1951. Amar Bose founded the Bose Corporation in 1964. Charles Wang founded Computer Associates, later became its CEO and chairman. David Keim founded hip-hop fashion giant Southpole Clothing in 1991. Gen Hsun Huang Co. founded the Nvidia Corporation in 1993. Jerry Yang Co. founded Yahoo Inc. in 1994 and became its CEO later. Andrea Yung serves as chairman and CEO of Avon Products. Vinod Khosla was a founding CEO of Sun Microsystems and is a general partner of the prominent venture capital firm Kleiner Perkins Coefield. Kareem were co-creators of YouTube, and were beneficiaries of Google's $165 billion acquisition of that company in 2006. In addition to contributing greatly to other fields, Asian Americans have made considerable contributions in science and technology in the United States. In such prominent innovative are Network, reporting for CBS in 1971. She later co-anchored the CBS Evening News from 1993 to 1995, becoming the first Asian American national news anchor at ABC. Ken Kasiwahara began reporting nationally in 1974. In 1989, Emil Guillermo, a Filipino-American-born reporter from San Francisco, became the first Asian American male to co-host a national news show when he was senior host at National Public Radio's All Things Considered. In 1990, Cheryl Wudun, a foreign correspondent in the Beijing bureau of the New York Times, became the first Asian American to win a Pulitzer Prize. Ann Curry joined NBC News as a reporter in 1990, later becoming prominently associated with The Today Show in 1997. Carol Lynn is perhaps best known for being the first to break the news of 9/11 on CNN. Dr. Sanjay Gupta is currently CNN's chief health correspondent. Lisa Ling, a former co-host on The View, now provides special reports for CNN and The Oprah Winfrey Show, as well as hosting National Geographic Channel's explorer Fareed Zakaria, a naturalized Indian-born immigrant, is a prominent journalist, an author specializing in international affairs. He is the editor-at-large of Time magazine, and the host of Fareed Zakaria GPS on CNN. Juju Chong, James Hattori, John Young, Veronica de la Cruz, Michelle Malkin, Betty Nguyen, and Julie Chen have become familiar faces on television news. John Young won a Peabody Award. Alex Tyson, a Seattle Times staff writer, won a Pulitzer Prize in 1997. Military former Secretary of Veterans Affairs Eric Shinseki, previously, as the four-star chief of staff of the United States Army, Shinseki became the highest-ranked Asian American ever in the military. Main article, Military History of Asian Americans. See also, notable Asian Americans in the military since the War of 1812. Asian Americans have served and fought on behalf of the United States, serving in both segregated and non-segregated units until the desegregation of the U.S. military in 1948. 31 have been awarded the nation's highest award for combat valor, the Medal of Honor. 21 of these were conferred upon members of the mostly Japanese-American 100th Infantry Battalion of the 442nd Regimental Combat Team of World War II, the most highly decorated unit of its size in the history of the United States Armed Forces. Science and technology. Asian Americans have made many prominent and notable contributions to science and technology. Qian Xiang Wu was known to many scientists as the First Lady of Physics and played a pivotal role in experimentally demonstrating the violation of the law of conservation of parity in the field of particle physics. Fazlur Rahman Khan, also known as named as the father of tubular designs for high-rises, was highlighted by President Barack Obama in a 2009 speech in Cairo, Egypt, and has been called Einstein of structural engineering. Min Chua Chong was the co-inventor of the combined oral contraceptive pill and contributed significantly to the development of in vitro fertilization at the Worcester Foundation for Experimental Biology. David T. Wong was one of the scientists credited with the discovery of groundbreaking drug fluoxetine, as well as the discovery of atomoxetine, duloxetine and dapoxetine. With colleagues, Michio Kaku has popularized science and has appeared on multiple programs on television and radio. Award recipients Samuel Chow Chung Ting, Nobel Prize laureate, 1976. Sung Dao Lee and Chen Ning Yang received the 1950 1997 Nobel Prize in Physics for theoretical work demonstrating that the conservation of parity did not always hold and later became American citizens. Har Gobind Khorana shared the 1968 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for his work in genetics and protein synthesis. Samuel Chow Chung Ting received the 1976 Nobel Prize in Physics for discovery of the subatomic particle J. Psi. The mathematician Xing Tung Yao won the Fields Medal in 1982 and Terence Dao won the Fields Medal in 2006. The geometer Xing Shen Chern received the Wolf Prize in Mathematics in 1983. Andrew Yao was awarded the Turing Award in 2000. Subramanian Chandrasekhar shared the 1983 Nobel Prize in Physics and had the Chandra X-ray Observatory named after him in 1984. Dr. David D. Ho first reported the healthy carrier state of HIV infection, which identified HIV-positive individuals who showed no physical signs of AIDS. Charles J. Peterson shared the 1987 Nobel Prize in Chemistry for his methods of synthesizing crown ethers. Stephen Chu shared the 1997 Nobel Prize in Physics for his research in cooling and trapping atoms using laser light. Daniel Sui shared the 1998 Nobel Prize in Physics in 1998 for helping discover the fractional quantum Hall effect in 2008. Biochemist Roger Chen won the Nobel in Chemistry for his work on engineering and improving the green fluorescent protein GFP that has become a standard tool of modern molecular biology and biochemistry. Yoichiro Nambu received the 2008 Nobel Prize in Physics for his work on the consequences of spontaneously broken symmetries in field theories in 2009. Charles K. Kao was awarded Nobel Prize in Physics for groundbreaking achievements concerning the transmission of light in fibers for optical communication, and Venkatraman Ramakrishnan won the prize in chemistry for studies of the structure and function of the ribosome. Ching W. Tang was the inventor of the organic light-emitting diode and organic solar cell and was awarded the 2011 Wolf Prize in Chemistry for this achievement. Manjul Bhargava, an American-Canadian of Indian origins, won the Fields Medal in Mathematics in 2014. Shuji Nakamura won the 2014 Nobel Prize in Physics for the invention of efficient blue light-emitting diodes. Yitang Zhang is a Chinese-born American mathematician working in the area of number theory while working for the University of New Hampshire as a lecturer. Zhang submitted an article to the Annals of Mathematics in 2013 which established the first finite bound on gaps between prime numbers, which lead to a 2014 MacArthur Award. Space Lieutenant Colonel Ellison Onizuka, the first Asian American, and third person of Asian descent, in space. This section needs expansion with examples and additional citations. You can help by adding to it October 2009. See also, list of Asian American astronauts. LTC Ellison Onizuka became the first Asian American and third person of East Asian descent when he made his first space flight aboard STS-51C in 1985. Onizuka later died aboard the Space Shuttle Challenger in 1986. Taylor Gun Jin Wong became the first person of Chinese ethnicity and first Chinese American, in space in 1985. He has since been followed by Leroy Chow in 1994, and Ed Liu in 1997. In 1986, Franklin Chong Diaz became the first Asian Latin American in space. Eugene H. Trinh became the first Vietnamese American in space in 1992. In 2001, Mark L. Polanski, a Jewish Korean American, made his first of three flights into space in 2003. Kalpana Chawla became the first Indian American in space, but died aboard the ill-fated Space Shuttle Columbia. She has since been followed by CDR Sunita Williams in 2006. Sports basketball. Basketball player Jeremy Lin. Wataru Misaka broke the NBA color barrier when he played for the New York Knicks in the 1947-48 season. The next Asian American NBA player was Raymond Townsend, who played for the Golden State Warriors and Indiana Pacers from 1978 to 1982. Rex Walters played from 1993 to 2000 with the Nets, Philadelphia 76ers, and Miami Heat. He is presently the head coach for the University of San Francisco basketball team after playing basketball at Harvard University. Point guard Jeremy Lin signed with the NBA's Golden State Warriors in 2010 and now plays for the Brooklyn Nets. Current Kansas Jayhawks assistant coach Curtis Townsend, as Raymond Townsend's brother Eric Spoelstra became the youngest coach ever in NBA history. He is currently the head coach of the Miami Heat football. This section needs additional citations for verification. Please help improve this article by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. December 2012. Learn how and when to remove this template. message Wally Yonemine as a giant in 1951 in football. Wally Yonemine played professionally for the San Francisco 49ers in 1947. Norm Chow is currently the head coach for the University of Hawaii and former offensive coordinator for UCLA after a short stint with the Tennessee Titans of the NFL. After 23 years of coaching other college teams, including 4 years as offensive coordinator at USC in 1962, half-Filipino Roman Gabriel was the first Asian American to start as an NFL quarterback. Dat Nguyen was an NFL middle linebacker who was an All-Pro selection in 2003 for the Dallas Cowboys in 1998. He was named an All-American and won the Bednarik Award as well as the Lombardi Award, while playing for Texas A. Sammy Lee, first Asian American Olympic gold medalist. Asian Americans first made an impact in Olympic sports in the late 1940s, and in the 1950s Sammy Lee became the first Asian American to earn an Olympic gold medal, winning in platform diving in both 1948 and 1952. Victoria Manalo Draves won both gold in platform and springboard diving in the 1948. Harold Sakata won a weightlifting silver medal in the 1948 Olympics, while Tommy Kono weightlifting, Yoshinobu Oyakawa 100-meter backstroke, and Ford Kono 1500-meter freestyle each won gold and set Olympic records in the 1952 Olympics. Kono won another gold and silver swimming medal at the same Olympics and added a silver medal in 1956, while Kono set another Olympic weightlifting record in 1956 also at the 1952 Olympics. Evelyn Kawamoto won two bronze medals in swimming. Amy Chow was a member of the gold medal women's gymnastics team at the 1996 Olympics. She also won an individual silver medal on the uneven bars. Gymnast Mahini Bardwaj won a team silver medal in the 2004 Olympics. Brian Clay, who is of half Japanese descent, won the decathlon gold medal in the 2008 Olympics, the silver medal in the 2004 Olympics, and was the sport's 2005 world champion, since Tiffany Chin won the women's U.S. figure skating championship in 1985. Asian Americans have been prominent in that sport. Christy Yamaguchi won 3 national championships, 2 world titles, and the 1992 Olympic gold medal. Michelle Kwan has won 9 national championships and 5 world titles, as well as 2 Olympic medals, silver in 1998, bronze in 2002. Apollo Ono, who is of half Japanese descent, is a short track speed skater and an 8-time Olympic medalist, as well as the most decorated American Winter Olympic athlete of all time. He became the youngest U.S. national champion in 1997 and was the reigning champion from 2001 to 2009, winning the title a total of 12 times in 1999. He became the youngest skater to win a World Cup event title, and became the first American to win a World Cup overall title in 2001, which he won again in 2003 and 2005. He won his first overall world championship title at the 2008 championships. Nathan Adrian, who is a Hapa of half Chinese descent, is a professional American swimmer and 3-time Olympic gold medalist who currently holds the American record in the 50 and 100-yard freestyle short course events. He has won a total of 15 medals in major international competitions, 12 gold, 2 silver, and 1 bronze, spanning the Olympics, the World, and the Pan-Pacific Championships. Other sports. Michael Chong. This section needs expansion with examples and additional citations you can help by adding to it. February 2012. Michael Chong was a top-ranked tennis player for most of his career, and the youngest ever winner of a Grand Slam tennis tournament in men's singles. He won the French Open in 1989. Tiger Woods, who is partially of Asian descent, is the most successful golfer of his generation and one of the most famous athletes in the world. Eric Kostin is one of the top street skateboarders and placed first in the 2003 10th Games street competition. Richard Park is a Korean-American ice hockey player who currently plays for the Swiss team HC Ambry Piata. Brian Ching, whose father was Chinese, represented the United States men's national soccer team, scoring 11 goals in 45 caps. He participated in the 2006 World Cup and won the 2007 Gold Cup. Julie Chu, who is 3/4 Chinese and 1/4 Puerto Rican, is an American Olympic ice hockey player who played for the United States women's ice hockey team. She was also U.S. Olympic team flag bearer for the 2014 Winter Olympic closing ceremonies. Cultural influence. In recognition of the unique culture, traditions, and history of Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders, the United States government has permanently designated the month of May to be Asian Pacific American Heritage Month. Health and medicine. See also, health status of Asian Americans. Asian immigrants are also changing the American medical landscape through increasing number. Of Asian medical practitioners in the United States beginning in the 1960s and 1970s, the U.S. government invited a number of foreign physicians, particularly from India and the Philippines, to address the acute shortage of physicians in rural and medically underserved urban areas. The trend in importing foreign medical practitioners, however, became a long-term, chronic solution as U.S. medical schools failed to produce enough physicians to match the increasing American population amid decreasing interest in medicine among American college students due to high educational costs and high rates of job dissatisfaction, loss of morale, stress, and lawsuits. Asian American immigrants maintained a supply of healthcare practitioners for millions of Americans. It is well documented that Asian American international medical graduates, including highly skilled guest workers using the J-1 visa program for medical workers, tend to serve in health professions shortage areas HPSA and specialties that are not filled by U.S. medical graduates, especially primary care and rural medicine. Thus, Asian American immigrants play a key role in averting a medical crisis in the U.S. A lasting legacy of Asian American involvement in medicine is the forcing of U.S. medical establishment to accept minority medical practitioners. One could speculate that the introduction of Asian physicians and dentists to the American society could have triggered an acceptance of other minority groups by breaking down stereotypes and encouraging trust. Traditional Asian concepts and practices in health and medicine have attracted greater acceptance and are more widely adopted by American doctors. India's Ayurveda and traditional Chinese medicine, which also includes acupuncture, are two alternative therapy systems that have been studied and adopted to a great extent. For instance, in the early 1970s, the U.S. medical establishment did not believe in the usefulness of acupuncture. Since then, studies have proven the efficacy of acupuncture for different applications, especially for treatment of chronic pain. It is now covered by many health insurance plans. Herbalism and massage therapy from Ayurveda are sweeping the spas across America. Meditation and yoga from India have also been widely adopted by health spas, and spiritual retreats of many religious bases. They are also part of the spiritual practice of the many Americans who are not affiliated with a mainline religious group. Origins of foreign doctors in the U.S. Country of origin. Percentage of total IMGs in U.S. India 199%, 47,581 Philippines 88%, 20,861 Pakistan 48%, 11,330 South Korea 21%, 4,982 China 20%, 4,834 Origins of foreign dentists in the U.S. Country of origin. Percentage of total IDGs in U.S. India 258 Philippines 110 China 32 South Korea 32 Pakistan 29. Origins of foreign nurses in the U.S. Country of origin. Percentage of total INGs in U.S. Philippines 502 India 13 Hong Kong 12 Israel 10 South Korea 10 Education. Educational attainment 25 and older. Ethnicity. High school graduation rate 2004 bachelor's degree or higher 2010 Filipinos 908%, 481% Indian 902%, 707% Pakistanis 874%, 551% Bangladeshis 845%, 496% Chinese 808%. 518% Japanese 934%, 473% Koreans 902%, 529% Vietnamese 700%, 263% Total U.S. population 839%, 279% Sources, 2004 and 2010. Among America's major racial categories, Asian Americans have the highest educational qualifications. This varies, however, for individual ethnic groups. Dr. Cien La, Director of the Asian Americans, have a degree attainment rate of only 16%, while Laotians and Cambodians only have rates around 5%. It has been noted, however, that 2008 U.S. Census statistics put the bachelor's degree attainment rate of Vietnamese Americans at 26%, which is not very different from the rate of 27% for all Americans according to the U.S. Census Bureau in 2010, while the high school graduation rate for Asian Americans is on par with those of other ethnic groups. 50% of Asian Americans Americans have attained at least a bachelor's degree as compared with the national average of 28%, and 34% for non-Hispanic whites. Indian Americans have some of the highest education rates, with nearly 71% having attained at least a bachelor's degree in 2010 according to Carolyn Chen, director of the Asian American Studies Program at Northwestern University. As of December 2012, Asian Americans made up 12 to 18% of the student population at Ivy League schools, larger than their share of the population. For example, the Harvard class of 2016 is 21% Asian American. In the years immediately preceding 2012, 61% of Asian American adult immigrants have a bachelor or higher level college education. Social and political issues. Illegal immigration. In 2012, there are 13 million alien Asian Americans, and for those awaiting visas, there are lengthy backlogs with over 450,000 Filipinos, over 325,000 Indians, over 250,000 Vietnamese, and over 225,000 Chinese are awaiting visas as of 2009. Filipinos and Indians accounted for the highest number of alien immigrants for Asian Americans, with an estimated illegal population of 270,000 and 200,000 respectively. Indian Americans are also the fastest growing alien immigrant group in the United States, an increase in illegal immigration of 125% since 2000. This is followed by Koreans 200,000 and Chinese 120,000 due to the stereotype of Asian Americans being successful as a group and having the lowest crime rates in the United States. Illegal immigration is mostly focused on those from Mexico and Latin America, while leaving out Asians. Asians are the second largest racial, ethnic alien immigrant group in the U.S. behind Hispanics and Latinos. While the majority of Asian immigrants to the United States immigrate legally, up to 15% of Asian immigrants immigrate without legal documents. Deportation of Cambodians from the United States. Main article: Deportation of Cambodians from the United States. Deportation of Cambodians from the United States typically refers to the forced repatriation of Cambodians who are convicted criminals in the United States and lack United States citizenship. Race-based violence. See also: Yellow Peril, Anti-Chinese Sentiment in the United States, Anti-Japanese Sentiment in the United States, and Anti-Pakistan underscore sentiment section. American students by their black classmates have been reported in multiple cities. In October 2008, 30 black students chased and attacked 5 Asian students at South Philadelphia High School, and a similar attack on Asian students occurred at the same school 1 year later, prompting a protest by Asian students in response. Asian-owned businesses have been a frequent target of tensions between black and Asian Americans during the 1992 Los Angeles riots. More than 2,000 Korean-owned businesses were looted or burned by groups of African Americans from 1990 to 1991. A high-profile, racially motivated boycott of an Asian-owned shop in Brooklyn was organized by a local black nationalist activist, eventually resulting in the owner being forced to sell his business. Another racially motivated boycott against an Asian-owned business occurred in Dallas in 2012, after an Asian American clerk fatally shot an African American who had robbed his store. Racial stereotypes. Main articles: Stereotypes of East Asians in the United States and Stereotypes Types of South Asians. See also: Ching Chong. Until the late 20th century, the term Asian American was adopted mostly by activists. While the average person of Asian ancestries identified with their specific ethnicity, the murder of Vincent Chin in 1982 was a pivotal civil rights case, and it marked the emergence of Asian Americans as a distinct group in United States. Stereotypes of Asians have been largely collectively internalized by society, and these stereotypes have mainly negative repercussions for Asian Americans and Asian immigrants in daily interactions, current events, and governmental legislation. In many instances, media portrayals of East Asians often reflect a dominant Americentric perception rather than realistic and authentic depictions of true cultures, customs, and behaviors. Asians have experienced discrimination and have been victims of hate crimes related to their ethnic stereotypes. Study has indicated that most non-Asian Americans do not generally differentiate between Asian Americans of different ethnicities. Stereotypes of Chinese Americans and Asian Americans are nearly identical. A 2002 survey of Americans' attitudes toward Asian Americans and Chinese Americans indicated that 24% of the respondents disapprove of intermarriage with an Asian American, second only to African Americans. 23% would be uncomfortable supporting supporting an Asian American presidential candidate, compared to 15% for an African American, 14% for a woman and 11% for a Jew. 17% would be upset if a substantial number of Asian Americans moved into their neighborhood, 25% had somewhat or very negative attitude toward Chinese Americans in general. The study did find several positive perceptions of Chinese Americans: strong family values 91%, honesty as business people 77%, high value on